when you're living in an RV or a van, trash becomes a problem. It's one of the things you don't think about when you become a nomad, maybe as much as other things. So today I'm going to give you strategies for how to cut down on your trash, where to take your trash, and also how you can find recycling while you're on the road. Hey everybody, it's Robin with Creativity RV, and welcome to episode 15 of Be a Nomad, Change Your Life, my Sunday series where I try and give you every tool and tip that you need to hit the road full time. And recently I was talking to a group of my friends about the biggest differences they found between a sticks and bricks life and a nomadic life. And at the top of the list for everybody was trash. Now, you may not have considered trash if you haven't hit the road yet, or if you're already on the road, then this is something that you're dealing with, because if you live in a small space like a van or an RV, first of all, you don't have a lot of room to store your trash. I don't know about you guys, but I don't have an extra bin in here where I can store my trash, so that was something I really had to figure out. Another thing I had to figure out was where to put the trash as it piles up, how to keep it so it doesn't smell if it takes me a couple of days to get rid of it, and then where I can actually get rid of it where nobody's gonna yell at me, because as you know, a lot of places have signs on their dumpsters that say, no household trash here. When I go to the store, the very first thing I do as I'm putting my groceries away before I leave the grocery store is I take every possible thing out of its package that I can, and I put it into smaller packaging so I can get rid of the big bulky packaging that those items came in before I hit the road. That way it doesn't end up in my trash can. So let me give you some examples. Here, I bought some items to replace some other items that were running out, like mouthwash and micellar water. And so I just empty the old one into the new one so that I can throw the old one away, and that way it doesn't end up in my trash. I also take out any kind of food that I can and store it so that it takes up less room and stays longer. Like here, for example, I got a big bag of peaches because they're in season here and they're delicious, but I didn't want to keep them in this plastic because I have to throw that away. So I took it out of the plastic and I hung it in a bag that I keep all my produce in. I'll put a link for that below if anybody needs some produce bags. But that helps me keep my produce so it can swing instead of bumping into stuff, and it stays longer, and then I don't have to deal with the trash. But the biggest thing that I do, you'll see here. So you guys know that I went to the Celestial Seasonings tour where I got this shirt and got a whole bunch of tea, and I've been amazed at how fast I've really gone through the tea. But you're gonna see here in this clip that I have a giant plastic bag full of smaller plastic bags that are full of tea, because I didn't have room to store 40 boxes of Celestial Seasonings tea, right? So this is a tip I learned from my friend Tiki from Find It With Tiki, Organizational Genius. As soon as I come into my RV from the store, I take the tea out of its box and I put it into a plastic bag, and then all the plastic bags are sealed into a big plastic bag and put into the cupboard. Now, people, bag police, before you put your comments below, let me tell you, I reuse my bags, as you can see here. So I'm actually using a lot less plastic than maybe another person would, because things like this that I use over and over, I store in the same bags over and over. And then I just crush the box and I put it into my recycling bag to go and recycle. So you guys get the idea. When you come in from the store and you're putting your groceries away, try and look at what kind of packaging you can get rid of right away. So like, I bought a new pair of earbuds. I took them out of the package right away and threw away the packaging so that that doesn't end up in my own trash can later. So now that we've talked about cutting down on how much trash you have, let's talk about where to store it. So yes, I do keep the little grocery plastic bags handy, and I use those so that I have a smaller container that I can just fill up and I can just dump into a trash can and nobody's gonna yell at me. So as I go into a grocery store, or I'm going to a visitor center in a town like I am right now, I can just put a little tiny package of trash into their trash can and nobody's going to have a problem. But these bags do tend to leak. So when I'm boondocking, I do something else. This is a shot of my shower, and you're going to see a giant laundry container in the shower. I do not put my laundry in there. My laundry bag is over where my clothes are. This had a big, broad base, so it wouldn't fall over while I was driving. That's why I chose this. And it keeps any leaking trash from going into my shower floor. So what I do is I put a big trash bag in there, and then I put my smaller trash bags into the big bag, as I accumulate it so that when I'm done boondocking, I have one or two big trash bags that I can get rid of. When I wasn't doing this, I was storing lots of little bags of trash in my shower, and then when I wanted to go throw it away, they were leaking, they smelled, and they were being jostled around while I was driving. So this is the solution that I came up with. It works really great for me. Another thing that I do that might work for you is I couldn't find a place to put a trash can. So I got one of these little skinny trash cans like you see here, and I actually found a place up on my wall where I could stick it up there with industrial Velcro. So you guys, industrial Velcro will stick just about anything to anything. I'll put a link for that below as well in case you need some. But I just put it on the two sides and the back. So I have Velcro strips on three sides of this trash can, and I stuck it up there. And the trash can can come down, but I don't take it down that much. I just take the bag in and out, and that works great for me. Another thing I do to keep my trash low is that I keep a Trader Joe's paper bag handy, and I put all of my paper stuff in there so that when I have a fire, I can burn it. So in a nutshell, here are my tips. You cut down on the trash you're going to have by getting rid of packaging right at the store before you drive away. Use your little plastic bags for little satchel containers that you can throw away easily. But if you're boondocking, try and get a bigger container that they can go into in a bigger bag, because it's going to be less mess and less smell. And if you need to put a trash can up somewhere, try Velcro. It works great. Now, let me tell you my secret for finding trash cans and recycling on the road. And this is for my friend Lisa, who is really careful about her recycling and has trouble finding it on the road. Well, you guys know that when you go to a campground or even a Walmart or a visitor center, something like that, they'll have one dumpster, but usually there is no separate recycling. So I use my go-to trick that I use all the time for all kinds of things, and that is that I Google recycling center near me. And today I'll tell you that I'm in a little town in Colorado at the visitor center where I'm using their Wi-Fi and went in and chatted the person up about the area. When I came out, I put in recycling center near me, and it's half a block that way. So I'm going to take my trash down there and put it in, and you can see that they actually separate the trash from the recycling. So whenever you're going into a small town, they may not have recycling separated like they do in some bigger cities, but most of them do have a central location where they pool the recycling together, and I find that easily if I just Google it. So you guys, I hope this was helpful for you. Please share it with your friends if they can use it. Do stop, please, and take a minute to give me a thumbs up on the way out. If you haven't subscribed already, please do. Come back next week for the next episode of Be a Nomad, Change Your Life. Everybody have happy travels out there, and be free.